Hey guys, what's up? My name is PeepBreaker, and in today's video, I'm going to show you the best possible settings for recording using OBS Studio. Now, the three goals of these settings were really having the least amount of lag while gaming, having the best possible image quality while still retaining the smallest file size possible. Now, I have listed all of the different topics considered in this video in the description box below, so if you're only interested in one specific subject, you can just skip ahead to that part. But now, let's get into the video. Alright, now to start off with, you always want to use the 64-bit version of OBS Studio. If you don't know where to find it, you can go to C, Program Files, x86, OBS Studio, bin, 64-bit, and here you'll find the OBS 64-bit exe. Alright, now the second thing is that you always want to run OBS Studio as an administrator. This is really important because some games don't allow you to capture the game if OBS Studio isn't run as an administrator. Now, once you're in OBS Studio, you always want to do a new profile. So we're going to call this YouTube tutorial because, well, it's my YouTube tutorial. As well as a new scene collection. Now, this is really important because if you mess up any of the settings, then you can simply go back to your old settings and you don't have to find them once again. And additionally, it's also very handy to have one set of settings for recording and one for streaming. Alright, now once you have your new profile and scene collection, you want to set up your canvas size. So go to settings, go to the video tab, and now set up your base and output resolution according to your monitor that you have. Now I have a 2K monitor, so I'm gonna select the 2560x144p, but obviously if you have a 1080p monitor, you wanna select 1920x1080 for both of those. Now for the downscale filter, obviously since we're not downscaling at this point, we wanna use bilinear. And here's actually a comparison of using these three different filters while actually not downscaling. And as you can see, using bilinear produces the best possible video quality, especially considering the ocean. And if you look for these ripples, you can see they are much better resolved using bilinear. Now for FPS, we're obviously going to go with 60 FPS. This is just a new standard and it's very noticeable if a video on YouTube is, for example, only on 30 FPS. Now to record your games, you want to right click on sources, click on Add, click on Game Capture, name it whatever. Now you can either select Capture any full screen application or capture a specific window, and then you can select it here under the Window tab. But I personally always just go with Capture any full screen application because usually OBS Studio can pick up on the game that I like. Now I would always recommend you to use Game Capture here. This definitely uses up a lot less resources than using Display Capture. The only downside is that some games might not support game capture. So in that case, or if you want to record your desktop, you're gonna click on right click on sources, click on add, click on display capture, and then you can select the display if you have multiple, and you can select if you want to have your cursor enabled or not, and you're good to go. Alright, as a next step, we want to set up the audio. For that, we're gonna head to settings, go to audio. Now, we have to check a few things. First of all, right-click on the little speaker icon in the taskbar, click on Playback Devices. Now, right-click on the audio device that you're usually using, click on Properties, Advanced, and here you can see the sample rate. So if this is on 48,000, you want to select 48,000. Obviously, you should do the same thing with the sample rate for the microphone and make sure it's also set to the same as your speakers. Then select your desktop audio device. In my case, this is the headphones 2 Series Arc Disc Gaming, as well as your standard mic. And in my case, this is the Blue Yeti microphone. Hit apply and restart OBS Studio. Now, one last thing that we have to do with the audio is that we want to separate the audio tracks. So we want to have one channel for the microphone and one channel for the game audio. In order to do so, click on this cog icon in the mixer section, click on Advanced Audio Properties, and now select the track number 1 for the desktop audio, and deselect all of these other ones, and select track number 2 for microphone. Then finally, you obviously might want to adjust your levels, and that is all you have to do regarding your audio. Now let's get into the media things. Let's go to settings and to the output tab. And the first thing you want to do is switch the output mode to advanced. Then go to the recording tab, since we're not doing anything else with this profile. Select a recording path. And ideally, this is a very fast hard drive. If you can put it onto an SSD, then that would be ideal. But it also works with just a regular hard drive that's actually quite speedy. In my case, I'm gonna put it to data and to OBS. Now we wanna select the MP4 recording format. Then select audio track 1 and 2, because we obviously wanna record both the desktop and the microphone. And then let's head on to the encoder settings. Now, this is actually quite dependent on the hardware that you're on. So I, for example, have a GTX 1080 graphics card and an i7-77K CPU clocked at 4.9 GHz. And if you're interested in any of the other parts that I have in my PC, there's a link in the description box below where you can check out all of my specs. Now, if you do have an NVIDIA GPU, then I highly recommend to use the NVENC, which stands for NVIDIA Encoding Format. If you have an AMD card, on the other hand, you can use the AMD H.264 encoder. Now, if you don't have any of these two, you can still use QuickSync, which is not quite as good. Or if you still don't have that, then you're gonna have to use X264. But I really, really highly discourage from using X264, because it is actually using up a lot of resources on your computer. So if you're gaming and you're recording with X264, you will notice it. You will have lag and your game is not going to be smooth at all. Don't rescale output here. Again, if you want to rescale output, do it in the video tab and not in the output tab, because this will use much more of your CPU power as opposed to the GPU. Next, you want to select constant bitrate as a rate control, and let's move on to the bit rates. Now, the first thing that I wanted to investigate was what kind of performance hit you're gonna have to expect when recording using different bit rates. So here's a graph showing you the benchmark performance while having OBS closed. So this is just a regular benchmark on top. Then you can see what the performance decreases to when only opening up OBS Studio. So you can see we lose around 4 to 5 frames per second on average. And then you can see the performance hit while actually recording. And this is actually quite interesting, because as you can see, it doesn't really matter if you're recording with 40,000 or 70,000 kilobits per second, the performance hit is always going to be the same. Now here's a comparison between different bit rates using a 2K monitor. And I've produced this comparison using, first of all, the recording of the GTA 5 benchmark using a bitrate of 100,000. And then I've recorded this very video to get a frame by frame comparison of different bit rates. So this is the difference between 100,000 and 20,000. And as you can see, the ocean looks very blocky and all of the trees look super blocky compared to the 100,000 bit rate. Basically, you don't want to go that low. Now moving on to 40,000, which is this recording here. And as you can see, you still don't get any of the ripples on the ocean. This is 100,000. Once again, 40,000. However, the trees look already pretty nice. Moving on to 50,000, we can see that the ripples on the ocean are still not visible. However, the trees are now nicely resolved. Next, we have 60,000, and now it's becoming increasingly difficult to spot the difference. So this is 100,000, and this is 60,000. And you can see that maybe down here we have a little bit less detail with the 60,000. And once again, we don't get any ripples in the ocean. And finally, we head on to 70,000, which is the recommended bitrate for recording with 2K resolution, in my opinion. So this is with 70,000 and with 100,000. And you can see that slowly but steadily, we get to resolve some of the ripples on the ocean. The trees look rather nice. And overall, we don't have any blocks as compared to the lower bitrates. So if you're playing games with a lot of textures such as Arma 3 or PUBG or GTA 5, then I definitely recommend a bitrate of 70,000. And if you're playing games such as CSGO, you can definitely go a bit lower, for example 60,000. However, if you're on a 1080p monitor, then you should definitely select 40 or 50,000. Now, one last bit of advice is don't go too high with the bitrates. You should really find a good balance between having nice image quality and being able to edit your footage, because if you go too high, you might run into issues when editing your clips. Keep keyframe interval at 0, use the high quality preset, the high profile, and definitely untick two-pass encoding. That just doesn't make sense for recording. Next, we want to go to the audio tab, and here we definitely want to select 320 as the audio bitrate for track 1, which is the desktop, as well as track 2, which is the mic. Alright, now last but not least, let's head over to the advanced tab. First of all, we want to select the process priority to high. And this is important because we want to have as much CPU resources for OBS Studio as possible. Now, this makes sense because having a smoother recording is much more important than having more FPS in game, because usually you're above 60 FPS anyways. So if you drop a few FPS, that's not really an issue. But if your gameplay recording is becoming stuttery, then that is really annoying. And finally, let's head to the color space and the color range. Now on your screen right now, you can see a comparison of using the full versus the partial color range, as well as the different color spaces. Obviously, the partial color range gives you kind of washed out colors. Everything looks a little bit dull, and therefore the partial color ranges I really would not recommend. However, using the full color range, it's actually quite hard to decide between the 709 and the 601 color space. Now, in my opinion, especially looking at this very dark image here, I do tend to prefer the 601 color space, as I just think the colors look much more natural and just nicer overall. But this is actually quite a personal thing, and you kind of have to decide which kind of color space you'd like to use for yourself. So that's it. Those are, in my opinion and from my experience, the best possible recording settings using OBS Studio. If you still have any questions, don't hesitate to leave them in a comment section below. If you liked this video, leave a like. If you dislike it, leave a dislike. Thanks for watching, have a wonderful day, and I will see you guys in the next video.